Hi, I'm AJ, and thanks for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. If you're not a current member of the Mobile Money Nation, make sure you hit the subscribe button down below. Hit the like button because you're really gonna like this video. And also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I make a video. So this is a concept I've been thinking about for a long time. And if you know anything about the FIRE community, the Financial Independence Retire Early community, this is very similar to the way they approach saving for retirement and investing, but on a much smaller scale. So there are many companies out there that pay a dividend. So that means when you buy their stock, that company pays you every quarter or possibly every month a certain dollar amount or a certain amount of cents just for holding onto their stock. And many of these companies are whose services or products that you already use. So what if you could own the stock of the companies that you spend your money on a regular basis and actually have those companies pay your bills? This is where my thought of the can you pay my bills portfolio came up. And it's a fairly simple concept, and I'll use my Verizon wireless bill as the example. So let's say you have a $100 a month bill with Verizon. That's your phone bill, or maybe your cable or internet with Verizon Fios. And let's say you spend $100 every month on that bill. Now, if you were to buy Verizon stock, just one share, they would pay you 61.5 cents every quarter just for holding on to that one share of stock. Now, you own this share of stock, which means you own part of Verizon. And right now they pay 61.5 cents, which is about a 4% dividend yield. So every quarter they're gonna pay you 61.5 cents times however many shares that you own of Verizon stock. So if you think about every quarter, if you're paying your Verizon phone bill or cable or internet bill, and it's $100, then you would be spending $300 every quarter to Verizon to have that service. So to figure out how many shares of Verizon you would need to own in order to have Verizon via their dividend actually pay your phone bill, you would need to divide $300 by 61.5 cents. And that'll get you about 488 shares of Verizon. Now, for a $60 stock, 488 shares may sound like a lot of money, and it is for most people. And based on today's price, Verizon stock is around $60. That would be just over $29,000 in order for you to buy 488 shares of Verizon stock in order to have Verizon via its dividend pay your phone bill, which is $100 every month. Now, that is based on you buying all of the shares today. But think about how long you've been paying your phone bill or your cable or your light bill, or your gas bill. Think about all the bills you pay and how many years you have been paying them and how many years down the road you will be paying them for that service. So continuing using Verizon as the example, if we go back 5 years and we look at the price of Verizon stock, it has ranged anywhere from as low as $35 to as high as $60, where it's ranging right now. Now, if you were able to buy Verizon stock at its lowest point of $35 within the past years, then 488 shares would actually only be $17,000. But that also changes the amount of dividend that you're receiving for those shares, because over time, Verizon likes to increase their dividend, which makes it more enticing for people to want to own their stock. So 5 years ago, their dividend was only 55 cents instead of 61.5 cents. Of course, this changes the math as far as how many shares you need in order to pay your phone bill. So based on that 55 cent dividend, you would need to own 546 shares in order to pay that $100 phone bill over the course of a quarter. But if you bought them all at the same time at the point where Verizon stock was $35, then you would have only needed $19,000 in order to buy those 544 shares. Now, in comparison to the price of Verizon stock now and how much money you would need to buy Verizon stock now versus 5 years ago, there's a $10,000 difference in the amount of money that you would have needed to spend, as well as a 58 share difference in the number of shares that you'd have to purchase of Verizon stock. So had you bought 546 shares 5 years ago, then the amount of dividend that you're making now would actually be higher and you would have spent less money. So that 55 cents that you started off getting the dividend 5 years ago, and you have 546 shares instead of 488 shares. So you're now getting that 61.5 cent dividend times 546, which would give you a dividend payment of $335.79 for that quarter. So instead of $300, you begin $335 if you started and you had the whole amount of shares that you needed 5 years ago when the price of Verizon stock was at $35. That's more than enough to pay for an upgrade of your Android or your Apple phone, and of course to pay your phone bill and have a little bit money extra. And in addition to having that extra money that you would be making from the dividends because you have more shares, you would have also gained money in the Verizon stock over the course of that time. You would have over $10,000 more in value than you would now, because the price of the stock has gone from $35 to $60. But of course, not everyone has $29,000 or even $19,000 that they can fork over at one time to buy all of the shares that they would need to pay their phone bill. Now, if you go with the long-term plan and you put a little bit of money every month or every paycheck towards this goal of making this portfolio, in the next 5 or 10 years, you could have enough money to where you would be able to afford to pay your phone bill or your light bill or whatever bill you choose, just based on the dividends that you're gaining from these businesses. So sticking with that 5-year example, how much money per month would you have needed to save in order to buy $19,000 or $29,000 worth of Verizon stock? And that would be between $316 and $488 per month in order to save that amount of money in 5 years. Now, for some of you, that would be a lot of money to save per month, but there are others out there who this would not be a problem at all, as long as you're keeping a budget and you're staying focused with this long-term plan. But even better, what if you could lower your phone bill, so it's not $100, or your light bill, whatever the case is, if you could lower it to the point of maybe $25 or $40 or $50, the less your bill is, the less money you would have to save up and the less amount of stock that you would have to purchase in order for those dividends to take care of whatever bill that you want to pay. So using an example, if you had a $100 phone bill and you were able to get it down to $20 instead of the $100, you would only need 1/5 of the amount of shares that you would need to purchase of Verizon. So instead of 488 shares, right now you would only need 98 shares of Verizon in order to pay your phone bill, which means you'll need also 1/5 less the amount of money. So instead of $29,000, you would just need $5,800 in order to pay that $20 phone bill. And Verizon is just one example. If you have AT&T, you could use AT&T. If you have whatever company, it doesn't matter. You don't have to actually buy that individual company stock to pay for that same bill. But it's just the concept of thinking, okay, these are companies that I'm spending money with every month, and how can I actually gain from the fact that I am a loyal customer? There are many millions of loyal customers who are out there spending their money with these companies for decades, and how can I get something back from those companies that I know are going to be here for many years to come? Now, using AT&T as an example, their dividend yield is actually higher than Verizon's right now. Their dividend yield is just over 5%. The amount they pay in dividends is 51 cents, and their share price is around $38 at the moment. But there are also companies that pay monthly dividends. So using EPR Properties as an example, every month they pay a dividend. Every month they pay a dividend of 37.5 cents. Their stock price is around $78, and their dividend is about 6%. And so there are many companies out there, many businesses where you can invest your money, whether it's a cell phone company, an internet company like Comcast, a real estate investment trust, or even just using a Vanguard ETF that either follows technology, the total stock market, S&P 500, a REIT ETF. There are many ways that you can use stocks to receive dividends and then use those dividends to pay for your phone bills. So as I mentioned, just because you may use Verizon or you may use AT&T or you may use Comcast, it doesn't mean that you have to buy their stocks. But if you and millions of other people are also using those same companies, and these are businesses that are becoming more of a part of our lives every single day, we're using their products, and I really don't see companies like Verizon or AT&T or Comcast really going anywhere because we use their internet, we use their mobile phone services. It is something that is truly entwined into our lives. Like, we have our cell phones with us at all times. When we're at home, we're always on the internet. So these are companies that you could probably trust will be here 10, 20 years from now. Now, you don't have to invest in those specific companies. There are others out there as well. And like I mentioned, you can invest in real estate investment trusts. These are companies that usually pay a pretty high dividend compared to other businesses. And they own lots of properties, which may be restaurants. They may actually lease the Verizon stores or the AT&T stores or apartment buildings, healthcare service providers. There are lots of different REITs out there where you can use their services to actually make dividends and receive payments for owning their stock. So because you are a owner of their business by purchasing their stock, you can think of those businesses as actually being your employees. So they go out, they work for you, those companies, they make their money, and then they pay you for owning part of that company. And why not use that payment to pay for your daily expenses like your phone bill, your light bill, your gas bill, all of that. So companies, can you pay my bills? And I know you can. Many of these companies, if you look at, there's a group of stocks called like Dividend Aristocrats, and these are companies that have increased their dividend payments for many, many years. And so that means they plan on to continue to do that, unless for some reason they, you know, start losing money. You know, maybe they end up going bankrupt. Like, you know, there are companies that have been out there for many, many years, like Sears, and then all of a sudden they go bankrupt. So you want to look at companies that have consistently increased their dividend as companies that you want to look at to actually use this as your strategy. And if you really want to play it safe, you may get a lower dividend, but you can look at the total stock market ETF, the S&P 500 index fund, and use those Vanguard funds or any other company that creates a very low cost index fund or low cost ETF. Use those as options to receive dividends. Then you can use those dividends to pay for your daily expenses. So businesses, can you pay my bills? The great thing about this is that all the services that you're spending your money on and the products that you're spending your money on, you can actually have these businesses pay for those for you. So in a sense, you never actually spend any money, because if they're paying you dividend and you're using those dividends to then buy the products and services that you use, then you have actually haven't spent any money. And that only comes by being an owner in the business. When you own a business, even if it's a small part of a company, those companies, the people that work for those companies, they're working for you. Because as long as they're working and they're creating revenue, they're creating profit, they're growing, and those businesses are then paying you in dividends, they are working for you. So if you're interested in creating a portfolio like this, there's a really great platform that I like to use called M1 Finance. And with M1 Finance, you can automate the deposits into your brokerage account. You can automate the purchases of all of the stocks, all of the ETFs or index funds that you choose. That way you're just automatically putting money every week or every 2 weeks, every pay period that you have, and putting that money towards a pie, which is a group of stocks that you choose. That way you can continually invest, and over time, you'll eventually have enough money to pay all of your individual bills. So be sure to check that out. I have a link in the description, so you can click on that link and open an account. If you like, I also have a tutorial where I walk through step-by-step through the M1 Finance app to show you how to create a pie and how to use their app. And I also have a review that I did in the past. So I have two past videos, one as a tutorial, one as a review, to talk about all of the features of M1 Finance. So make sure you check those videos out. Thanks for watching. If you're not a part of the Mobile Money Nation, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. Hit the like button because you really like this video. And also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I make a video. Again, thanks for watching. You guys have a great day.